Hi everybody and welcome to the fifth one of our YouTube videos. I hope you're all well. Today we're going to be doing a flock of sheep and I've done them in really fun colours and they're a little bit abstract. So the idea with this one is that you do it pretty quickly, so it's obviously you're going to draw it out fast, but then the actual painting shouldn't take you longer than about 20 minutes or half an hour. So I just really want you to be free and easy with it. Try and let the colours flow, try not to get too fiddly with it all. So I'll show you the picture, the photograph that I will put on Facebook and on our WhatsApp group. And this is the flock of sheep and I have simplified it. So when you draw out, all you're gonna do is draw out these sheep at the front. I mean, you can go further back if you like, but just really, really simple drawing out, just an outline of an idea of where their eyes are and where their bodies are. So this is my finished piece. Thank you, Lulu, I'll just put it on there. And the finished piece, like I said, it's really fun colours, so I've got lots of gorgeous colours in there. And just an idea of where their eyes are. I haven't gone into so much detail. So if you compare these two sheep, you know, just an idea of their eyes, really. Idea of the light hitting the noses. And also I've blackened a lot of the faces, which isn't in the picture. So it's an artistic license there. Okay, and then added things like cauliflowers and fun bits. So we just get this idea of the gorgeous watercolours all blending and merging, you can see there. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, Lulu. Mm-hmm. Oh, the other thing I need to tell you actually is the colours I've used, that's very important. So I've used Elise Crimson, Ultramarine Blue, and then I've mixed the two colours to create this lovely purple, which I have used quite a bit in the work. I'll just show you. So we've got the purple tones and in their faces as well. So then we've got Raw Umber, which is a base wash that I've used. Payne's Grey, of course. It wouldn't be one of my artworks without it. That says Burnt Umber, actually it's Burnt Sienna. Sorry, I've got that wrong. That's Burnt Sienna. Viridian Hue, which is a bright turquoisey green. And then Ultramarine Blue, again, the two mixed together to make the turquoise that I've used to get this turquoise colour. Some of you will have turquoise, so just use that. You will already have a turquoise colour. Okay, so I'm just going to pop that there. Right, Lulu, we're ready to get started painting. Okay. Okay, so I'm just doing a size 6 brush, so only a little brush, and let's have a look. And then we're just going to start, we're just going to do one sheep at a time. So I'm just going to start with this sheep here, this large sheep on this side. And when you're drawing out, just try and get the lovely bend of the legs, you know, the funny little legs that they've got. When I draw out, I usually start by drawing a little line to indicate the feet, so that they don't get too spread apart. Because actually, when you look at the sheep, the feet are really, really close together. Okay, the legs are really close together. So just try and draw the legs first, then the body should follow quite easily from that. Okay, so let's start and make a purple. So I'm going to use my Elise Crimson here. We'll start with our faces. I've got Elise Crimson. And then I've got some Ultramarine Blue as well. There we are. So just a lovely soft purple colour, which actually is quite a natural looking purple. It's the Elise Crimson that makes it look quite natural. A lot more natural than just using Purple Lake. Okay, so we're just going to start with this little sheep's face. So just using my little brush, I'm just going to go around in my outline.
I'm going to leave part of his little face white. So I'm just going to just sort of indicate where this his nose is, about there, isn't it? And he's got his eyes about here. So I'm just very sketchily, maybe leaving just a little bit of the eye, but just try and be really sketchy about it. And then the ears. We don't have to fill in all the paper. We're just trying to be free and easy. So I've created a wet environment doing that. And now I'm going to go in with some of my blue, my ultramarine blue. And I'm just going to make that, just some of that a little bit stronger there. Just some of those highlights. So we've got some of the purple and the blue showing through, and now I want to darken that off. It's much too bright and vivid. So I'm just going to go in with some Payne's Grey, tapping my brush off, so making sure I don't have too much paint on my brush. And I'm just going to indicate, so this is where the darker bits will be, won't they? Because the light's hitting from the top. So we're going to have darker bits down here, under the eyes, and it's going to be a little bit lighter around the nose. So I can still see some of the other colours I put in. That's the idea. Okay, and if you feel that you've gone too far with it, it's fine. Clean your brush off, get a dryish brush. And we can just lift out a little bit on the bridge of that nose, like that. And just soften around his little face here. So you're in control. Just try not to lift out too much. You know, come back to it if you like. Just let it be and see how you go. So I can just see, I just don't like that expression that he's been left with. So I'm just going to darken up just above the eye there. Just have a little bit of a glint of an eye there. And then I'm going to pop his little face in now, little nose in Payne's Grey, a little bit of a smile, like so. Okay, a little bit darker there. So that's our first sheep gone, but you can see how there's different levels of tones there, there's different colours. You know, I can lift out a little bit more of his eye if I wanted to, but I really don't want you to fiddle too much with it all, okay? Going to cover that. Right, so now we're going to move on to his body. Okay, so I'm just going to get a slightly bigger brush. I'm going to get a number 8 and I'm going to use my raw umber. I've got a little bit of raw umber and just a tiniest bit of Payne's Grey just to dirty it up a bit, so it's that sort of a colour, and just the lightest of light washes. Okay, so let's get this on now. When we're doing it, well, when I'm doing it, I'm just thinking about the light. The light's hitting on his back. So I really don't want to put too much colour on at all. But we're just creating a wash. So just only a little bit of colour. I'm not covering all the sheep. Just a little bit here. So we can see how it's darker here, and it's much darker underneath. Okay. And then up his back a bit, and then maybe just cleaning my brush off. So all I've got is water, just a little bit of water from my brush, and I'm just moving that out. So I've hardly got any colour on his back at all there, but you can already see I've got a bit of shape happening, can't you? I'm just going to bring that down his legs. There we are. Okay, now let's go and put some lovely colours in. So let's get a little bit of burnt sienna. I'm sorry, I'd called it burnt umber in my earlier. It's burnt sienna. We're just going to get a flash of orange around his neck there and down here. Trying to get some texture in. And then I'm going to go get some of that gorgeous purple that we made for his face, which was the Lee's Crimson. Lee's Crimson and ultramarine blue, wasn't it? Let's get some of that in. and maybe a flash happening down here as well, and here down his leg, or her leg, I should say. Sorry, little Mishy. Yeah. And then I'm going to create some of my turquoise. So do you remember we had a little bit of the Viridian blue and some ultramarine blue. So my blue is staying the same throughout the painting, which will just makes it a little bit more pleasing as well. So the colours do blend quite nicely. So I've got a little bit of turquoise. And then we've got here, under here, it's really dark. So I'm just representing that at the moment with my dark turquoise. And you see how that's all bleeding up? And then we're really quite dark down this side of the sheep. So I'm just going to put a little bit more turquoise in there. And all these gorgeous colours are starting to appear now. I'm just going to get a lot less value of tone here, just to get a little hint of turquoise on his back. Okay, let's get a little bit of... So all I'm doing is trying to identify where it's light and dark, and just putting... It doesn't matter what colour you put. What matters is the tonal value that you put down. So if it's dark, it's a deep tone, it's a dark tone, it's a strong value. If it's light, it's just a light value. It doesn't matter what colour it is at all. Okay, so it's quite psychedelic at the moment. So I'm just going to dirty him up a bit. So I'm just going to get some of my Payne's Grey. And I'm just going to add a little bit of Payne's Grey here for that bit of his quite dark there, and up here as well. And then just up this side, just to give him that bit of shape. Can you see how we just up there? A little bit of my Payne's Grey. I'm going to go in with a bit more purple as well. That lovely purple that we've made. And actually just putting the purple in with the turquoise and the orange colours. We'll just start to dirty it up a bit as well. So there he is, starting to come together. And now I'm going to drag some of this colour down his leg. Okay. I'm not bothered about how the legs are finished. I'm just having an idea of them. And I can see that I just need to have a bit more tone here. So I'm adding a bit more Payne's Grey here, just to make that make sense. Okay. I just realised I'm missing a back leg, actually. Better just pop that in. It gets about here. There, can stand on four legs now, little my sheep. And then I'm just going to get a little bit of Payne's Grey and just put his little knock knees in. A little knock knee there, and a little knock knee there, and the thing at the back, but maybe just a bit more depth of colour. So you see, that easy and that quick, that is our first sheep done. So let's move on to our second one. I'm going to make some more purple up. Are you alright, honey? Are you comfortable, darling?
No. Yeah.
Okay. Okay, so just popping, starting again with my lavender colour, my purple colour, with this sheep in the background. Now, this sheep in the background, I'm not going to do its colours as vivid. I'm just going to knock the sheep back a bit with the colours. So the tonal value will be a lot lighter. Okay, so I'm just going to just maybe just put a little bit of, just dirty up that face a little bit. Just so it's not as strong as this face. And then with a little bit more of the blue, ultramarine blue now. Just like that, and then just a little bit. So you can see I've just not gone as dark with the colour on that sheep in the background, just to make it feel like it's in the background a little bit more. Okay, just going to add a little bit more colour on that one. Don't like the way that one's looking, that's better. Okay, so then we're just going to get a little bit of our raw umber. Sweetheart, are you more comfortable if you put your elbow on there, or are you comfy? I'm worried about you being uncomfortable.
I'm fine.
Okay, darling.
Thank you.
Okay, so my raw umber is just my wash. Just putting that on, it just stops the colours being too vibrant. I mean, you don't have to put this wash on. You can just go with your vibrant colours. And then just taking that down the legs, like that. Okay, so this little sheep's really dark under here and really dark here. So we're just gonna put stronger tonal values in. So I'm just gonna put a little bit of turquoise in this time to indicate that here and down there, okay? And then we're just gonna get a little bit of purple as well. And then I'm just gonna could put a little bit of Payne's Grey in. Just to say that's a lot darker. We're underneath there, there's not as much light hitting underneath this little sheep there. That's it, okay. And then we'll just say that that's his little knobbly knee, about here. Okay, that'll just bleed out a bit. Right. And should we give him a little face this way? He doesn't seem to have a face. Let's give him a little, sort of hidden behind that one, isn't he? There. Okay, let's move on to the next sheep. So this one's a lot larger now. And again, we've got light hitting here and we've got a lot of light hitting here. So we're going to indicate those with our lighter tonal values. So I'm going in with my raw umber again, my raw umber wash. I forgot to do his face first, never mind. Big woolly sheep. Alexa, play Joni Mitchell Blue. Right, so we've got that. Let's get some of these lovely colours on now. So we're going to go with our... Go with some burnt sienna under his little chin. There we are. And we'll just bring that down. We'll get some more of our purple. There we are. Amazing how it comes to life, isn't it, when you start doing those, some sweeping around under his neck as well, which really helps to get that shape or that woolly feeling of the of the sheep. Okay, I'm just making some more purple up. So let's just have a flash of purple there. And let's get lots of purple. Not purple, sorry, turquoise under here. I think I've gone mad then, Lulu.
Mm-hmm.
So it's really dark under there, isn't it? And my paint's drying now, so it's not bleeding as much, but it's okay. I can just use a dry brush and just move some of that paint around. So don't worry, or just wet it all again. That's darker there, isn't it? And then we're gonna go a lot darker here. And I think I'm just gonna put a little bit of blue in just because I feel like we haven't got much blue. So I've just added a bit more blue to that purple, but the purple's still showing. And then here at the back, so that I'm contrasting with that back sheep as well, is nice. Okay, I'm just going to give him a little bit of warmth so that it does contrast with that back sheep as well there. So let's just bring that warmth down. And remember that when we mix blue and burnt sienna, we do get a lovely grey colour anyway. Okay, so I've got a bit of a cauliflower that's going to appear there, but I'm really happy for that to happen. I'm going to let that be. I want it to feel like it's effortless. So I'm just going to go in with some of my Payne's Grey just to darken up underneath the sheep under here. And it is very wet, the sheep. I've got a lot of water on it, but like I say, I'm very happy for that to happen, for that naturally to happen. There. Right, I'm going to drag that colour down now. So I've got a bit of a wash. Just going to take a little bit of that colour down onto his little legs. Maybe get a little bit more turquoise coming down that leg, I think. Yeah, and that little bend that he's got there. Very cute. So I'll just have to wait for that to dry before I go in and do his face. I'm just gonna add a little bit more depth. Okay, let's do our next sheep now. So again, just going in with my lovely wash. So that was just a raw umber. So this sheep standing behind is a lot darker, so we're just going to get a little bit more tonal value in there. I'm just going to take that colour just down his legs. Okay, so I'm going to go with some purple, just make some more purple up. Just around here, just that depth of colour, and down here, on my arm, water on my, there. So I'm not going to add too much colour to this back sheep. A little bit of burnt sienna now. So just have a flash of orange in there and let that wash down. And then we're going to get some blue, some ultramarine blue on this one and under here and then a bit here. This is really dark, this sheep. Just bring it up. Cleaning my brush off, so it's just taking some of that colour up and just letting that blend. Okay, and let's give this one, well, he's already got some colour slipping down, so I'm just going to let that colour come down actually, because we've got some turquoise legs there, so let's let those be a little bit more purple in colour. Okay, and then we can just get some of our Payne's Grey and we can add that just here, for that really dark colour, contrasting with that sheep there. Okay, and then just some on his little knees in there. Okay, so I'll move back to doing this little sheep's face now. So remember how we did it, we went in with our purple. And we sort of know where the eyes are. So you can paint them or you can leave them white, but maybe just leave some of the purple showing through when you paint over the top, that's all. I am being very loose now. I haven't used a small brush. I used it at the beginning, but actually all the way through since then, I've just been using an 8, which should be fine for you. That little face. And then I'm just going to go in with some ultramarine blue. little flash of blue there on his ear. And then let's get some black, some Payne's grey, I should say. We'll just make his little face. Give him a little smile. It is springtime after all. And then darker here, because that's where the light's not hitting as much. See, I just don't want to put too much colour on, because I do like the purple and the blue shining through. Don't want to put too much Payne's grey on. Like that. And then if you feel it's too much, like I said before, you can just lift out just a little bit there. Just take a little bit on it off its nose. Like that. Okay. So we'll move on to the little sheep next door. More purple up in my palette. Okay, because this one's darker, isn't it, behind. We're just going to go a little bit darker with this one. So with this one, I'm not going to bother putting any blue on. I'm just going to go straight in with my Payne's grey. Because I just, like I said, I just don't want this one to stand out as much. Just knock it back in the background. Like that. And then what we can do is just take out just a little bit here on its forehead and down. So just a dry brush, just lifting out while it's wet, just that little bit of colour there. Okay, so we're almost there. Only two more sheep to go. What time are we on, Lou?
27 minutes.
27 minutes, so.
Now 28.
Oh, 28 minutes. Right, let's see if we can get it done. So we're going to go in with our wash. Right, honey. So I just think it's really important when you're doing it just to try and work on each individual sheep at a time, just to get that little bit of an expression and the difference between each one. And do try and go, obviously you can refer back to my finished piece, but do try and go, you know, refer to the photograph when you're doing it, because that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to learn all about these tones and how to represent them with these different colours. Okay, so I've gone in with a bit of turquoise, and now I'm going to grab a little bit of my burnt sienna. Just going to get a little bit more blue in that one, but I don't need to do much with this one in the background, because you can hardly see him. It's just an idea. I've got a bit of rubber in there. I'll just get a bit more blue there. That's it. I think that one's done. And then we've got our final sheep here with his head turned. Here we go, so final sheep now. There's a little eye about there. Little ear. An ear there. Sort of comes to about here, doesn't it? And then that shape, quite important, that shape underneath, just try and maintain that shape. Let's get a little bit of blue in there. Ultramarine blue. There we are. I'm just going to let that dry for a second while I put a wash on, and then we'll put a bit of Payne's Grey in his face. Okay, so same as before, same wash. That's too heavy of tones. I'm just getting a clean dry brush and I'm just moving that out. You can see how some of that colour's leaked through from his face. That's fine. We're trying to be very loose with this. So moving that colour down there. So I've created a wet environment like that. And then we can go in with some of our lovely colours. So our lovely turquoise, which I keep making up, and I keep making the wrong colour. One colour green, silly me. So we've got his neck that comes down. Can you see under here? Under his jaw? There, like that. And then here. And then under his tummy there. I'm going to go with a bit of blue on this one. Doesn't matter what colour you've got, as long as the tone's right, your tonal value's right. You can put any colour you like in. A bit of blue. Should we go for a stronger blue on this back leg? Take that down. I'm just going to put a little bit of orange in him as well. A little bit of burnt sienna. Just down his neck there. And then just maybe a bit here and here. And then I'm just going to get some Payne's Grey and let's get his face, rest of his face done. And little ear. There we are, and that little ear. I don't want him to have too much colour on his forehead because I didn't want to represent, have that light showing, which is represented by the under colour, the wash that we did underneath. Just gonna pull that up. Right, let's get some Payne's Grey. Here and under here too.